morning conjures thoughts of weekend cruises in striped jerseys and crusty old sea dogs. But prepare to think again. Tonight we meet two youthful sailors who thrive on high speed and adrenaline and plan to beat Britain's best later this year. Julie Scantlebury joined them for a sail in Torbay.
There's no room for error on a boat like Modi Kola. She's like the hot hatchback of the seas, small, fast and very exciting. Just the thing for two very young and ambitious sailors, 18-year-old David Barden and 21-year-old Alex Bennett. They've already completed the Fastnet race and now plan an assault on the internationally known Round Britain and Ireland race, which starts from Plymouth in June.
It's a really, really high-tech race. There's a lot of competition. It's a very hard race. There's serious stamina involved and just a generally good race today.
To be quite honest, it's 2,000 miles of racing around the UK, and it's going to take us across some of the most treacherous and navigationally challenging waters that Europe has to offer. Dave and I have both done transatlantic crossings before, which are twice as long, but they're really, to be quite honest, twice as easy.
The 30-foot boat has won her class in two previous Round Britains. This year, she faces bigger boats in a new class, but with several modifications like water ballast, Modi Kola is in the running. As for Alex and David, they may be one of the youngest crews, but winning is most certainly on their agenda. Julie Scantlebury in Torbay for West Country Live.
This is Yacht Modi Kola. We're Saturday the 6th of June, day before the start of the race. We're just putting final touches onto the boat, getting everything sorted out. Everything looks good so far. Looks like we're going to have fairly light winds for the start, probably from the southwest. And everyone in the fleet is busy getting their boats prepared, ready.
Done.
This is our force day. We did a rig check last night, and Dave went up the mast to check all the halyards and all the rigging, and we found this with all three broken strands. You can see here all these strands are broken, so we've replaced it now. Did a bit of running around, went into Cork, and got a new one made up. We've just fitted it, so we're back in the race. We'll be right back.
Saturday, can't remember what date it is, but we're about 15 miles from the finish. What you can see up here is Barra Head in the Outer Hebrides. Well, here we are, about 20 miles away from rounding St Kilda. We've got pretty much no wind at all. We've probably got about 5 knots of breeze, and we're sailing upwind. The sun's out, but it's actually incredibly cold here still. Obviously, we're quite a long way north, so it might look lovely on the camera, but in fact, it's actually quite cold. That's about all there is to say, really. It's a nice day, and nothing else to say.
And here we are, still trying to get around St Kilda Rock. Here we are, just round the Muggle Flutter, northernmost tip of England. Right, well, I don't know if you can see this on your TV screen, but this is Yacht Modi Cola on the fourth leg of the Round Britain and Ireland Yacht Race. It's sailed by Alex Bennett and Dave Barden. I'm just doing the commentary at the moment, and it's midnight on Saturday the 20th of June. We're off Sunbury Head, which is the southernmost tip of the Shetland Isles, and we're in thick fog. I don't know if you can see, but it's pretty damn serious fog. You cannot see probably two boat lengths in front of us, and we just had a bit of a scare by a tanker that's just gone past. We haven't seen it, but we've heard its engine. We very nearly had to put up a white flare because the engine was sounding so close. But as we say, that's just yacht race.
How hard we're pushing ourselves on the rocks. You can see Alex is falling asleep on the rail. Don't just both be steering the base at the moment.
Day three of the fourth leg, lower to Lowestoft. It's 11:30 on the morning of Tuesday the 23rd. It's 60 miles from the finish. We've got roughly 18 mile lead over Q2, who's back in third place. And we're sailing to windward in about 22 knots of breeze. We've got the typical North Sea short chop, which is a bit like the sort of sea you get in the Channel. It's quite aggressive, so the going is quite rough. Everything down below is absolutely soaked and drenched. David and I are both, or have both been in our dry suits from the start of this leg. I haven't taken them off once. But things look good at the moment. Our boat speed's pretty good. And we hope to be in Lowestoft early evening today. Sometimes ask me what open 30 sailing is like when you're offshore, when it gets a bit windy. Well, it's a bit windy, blowing nearly 30 knots, and we're sailing upwind in big seas. And you're looking at the cabin floor up forward, and you can see the whole boat is full of water. This is what it's like. Whoa, big wave. Can you zoom in here? We are beating to women on the last leg, and around about 4-8. UAB Marina. Monday morning. We finished last night at 20 past 11. And the result was third mono hull in our class, which is class 5. And first yacht under 34 feet. It's not a bad game, really.